Hi everyone, how do you do? 15 years ago, when I was writing my book, when I reached to the pivot table chapter, I was so excited. I still remember that day, because with the help of this feature, you can take a quick report from a huge amount of data. As I mentioned, today's video is about pivot table, and I'm gonna explain it in four different parts. In the first part of the video, you will learn the basic of the pivot table. You're gonna learn how to input data inside the pivot table. In the second part, we get to the details and we will learn how to add additional fields to the table. In the third part, I'll take you through how to add filters and slicers to the table. In the fourth part, you're gonna learn the setting for converting the table to a dynamic table. Are you ready for a quick report? Let's get started. This table has the selling information for a food company for 3 months. This company is selling 4 different products in America, Europe, and Asia, which are pasta, ketchup, garlic sauce, and olive oil. The company has told me to make a report for this table. To do that, I have to create a pivot table. Look at this table. There is a huge amount of information. Pivot table collects the information from this table and shows the useful information in a small and compact table. For example, if you look at this table, you'll see the sale amount for all products for each month. I get this information with only a couple of clicking. Isn't it awesome? So let's do it together. To create a pivot table, you just need to select one cell inside the table and from the Insert tab, click on the pivot table or you can click on the recommended pivot table. If you click on the recommended, Excel will suggest you some pivot tables based on your information in the table. But in this case, I want to create a blank pivot table, so I click on the pivot table icon. Excel automatically selects the range that your table is in it. Click on OK to create a pivot table. First, let me change the name of this sheet to Report. This is the environment of the pivot table. In the field section, you can see the headers of your table. All the headers of the selected table are sorted in this section. But these 4 sections are very important. We designed the pivot table in these sections. In the filter area, you can add a filter to the pivot table. In the columns and rows sections, you can add the information that you want to show them in columns or rows. And in the value section, you can add the data you want them to be calculated. Let me show you how to do that. I want to see the products in different rows. So I select the product in the above section and drag it to the row section. You can see all the products added to the table. Now I want to calculate the sale amount for each product. Did you hear me? I said calculate the sale amount. It means I have to drag the sale amount to the value section. Now you can see the summation of sale amount for each product. By default, Excel calculates the summation. But if you want to use other calculation types, right-click on the sum of sale amount and select the value field setting from the list. From here, you can select other calculation types. But in this case, I want the summation, so I click on cancel. For formatting the numbers, right-click on one number and select number format. In the Open It window, select the accounting in the category and set number 0 for decimal place and press OK. Now I want to add all the months to the columns. I drag the selling date field to the column section. When you drag the date to the column section, Excel automatically generates 2 new fields, the months and days. If you look at the table, there is a plus sign next to the name of each month. For example, I click on this plus button and you can see all the days in the January. But for me, the month is enough. and I don't want days in my table, so I have to remove them from the column section. For removing an item, you just need to drag and drop it to the outside of its section. So I remove these two items. Don't drop it here. It will transform to this section. Drop it outside. Looks good. Now I have the sale amount for each product for different months. We get this report only by a few clicking. Before I start the next part, please take a look to see if you have already subscribed to the channel or not. If you haven't, please consider subscribing. Let me add the product details to the row section too. I know it is getting a little confusing. For resolving this confusion, let me explain the table a little more. This table is a part of the source data. In the first column, we have product, and in the second column, we have product details. We dragged these two columns into the row section of the pivot table. For example, if you look at the ketchup, we have the product category at the top and the product with details in the subsection. Right now, we have the sale amount summation for all the products, and each product is placed under its category. If I click on the collapse icon, you can only see the sale amount for the products category. And if I click on expand, you can see the products with details. But maybe you ask, what are these? They are the subtotal of each product for each category. If I collapse the table, you only see the subtotals. But when I expand it, you will see the details too. But I personally don't like the subtotal in the above of the data. So let's change it. Select the Design tab and click on the Report Layout option and select Show in Tabular form. Now it's better. At least subtotals are in bottom. If you don't want to see the subtotal, you can deactivate it in the Subtotal section. Click on it and select Don't Show Subtotals. In the Grand Total section, you can specify whether you want the grand total in both directions or not. For example, if I select on four columns only, you can see the grand total only at the bottom of the table, and it will be removed from the side section. If you accidentally or for any reason close the pivot table fields, you can show it again by clicking on the field list icon. For simplifying the table, let me remove the product field from the row section and remove the months from the column section. We calculate the sale amount here, but we have to pay 20% of it as tax to the government. Now, I want to calculate the net profit, but we don't have the tax rate or net profit in the source data. How can we add a column that is not in the field section? For solving this problem, we have to define a new field to the field section. To do that, click on the Fields, Items, and Sets, and select Calculated Field. In this window, you can define a new field. In the Name section, I type Tax Amount. In the formula, you have to calculate the tax amount. It is equal to the sale amount, double-click on it, and multiply it by 20%. Press OK. You can see that the tax amount added to the table, and if you look at the fields, you can see that the tax amount field has been added to the field section. Now I want to calculate the net profit. Since net profit does not exist in the field section, we have to create a new field. I select calculated field, and for the name, I type net profit. For the formula, you can subtract the sale amount from the tax amount. And press on OK. Now the report is ready. We talked about everything except filters. For example, let me transform the months field to the filter section. You can see that the months filter was added at the top of the table. Now you can easily filter the data. For example, if you select March, you can see the March sale amount for all products. But I personally, instead of using the filter section, prefer to add a slicer. First, let me delete this. I want to filter data based on the region. In the filter group, click on Insert Slicer. In the Open It list, select the region and click on OK. The region slicer adds to the table. Right now, all regions are highlighted, which means all of them are selected. If I select Asia, you can see that the factory has only been able to sell two products in Asia. By selecting other regions, you can see the sale amount for each of them. But if you want to have multiple selections, you need to click on this icon, or you can hold the control key down. Now I want to see the sale amount for both Asia and Europe. I don't know if you noticed or not, when you select a slicer, the slicer tab adds to the tab ribbon. In this tab, you can edit the slicer. For example, I select three columns and you can see the result. You can also add a timeline to the table. Click on the Insert Timeline. It is only available for selling date. Select it and press OK. For a better view, first, let me set the same size for these two slicers. To do that, hold the Control key down and select both of them, and click on the Slicer tab. In the Size section, define the new height and width. And for alignment, click on Align icon and select the Align Left. Now you can easily filter your data. For example, let's see the sale amount in America in February. By default, month category is selected, but you can change it to year, quarters, or days. Let me select days. Now you can see the sale amount day by day, or you can select a specific range. And if you want to delete the slicers, select them and press delete on the keyboard. I want to add a new item to my source data. For example, I want to add honey product to the list. Okay, let's get back to the pivot table. Let me refresh the table, but I don't see any honey in the list. Why? If I click on change data source, this range is my selection and honey is not selected. And I don't want to, every time I add a new data to my source, come back and update it. Instead of that, I have a better solution. We need to convert the source data to a table. Select one cell inside the table and press Ctrl T. Excel selects the whole table. Click on OK. If you are like me and don't like the default format of the table, you can delete it from here. If you notice, the name of this table is Table 1. Let's get back to the pivot table. We need to change the data source. So click on it. You can select the table range or type in the name of it. I type Table 1 and press OK. From now on, every time you add a new data to the data source, Excel automatically adds it to the pivot table. For example, if I add honey to the table, and refresh the pivot table, you can see it in the list. Alright, it was all for today's video. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, ring the notification bell, and I'll see you next video.